Welcome to the part B of sequence to sequence learning tutorial series. In this tutorial, we will use several recurrent neural network models to solve the sample sequence to sequence problem introduced in part A. We will use LSTM as the recurrent neural network layer in Keras. If you would like to follow up all the tutorials, please subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow my blog on Medium. Thank you. Here you see my references and the resources that I used to prepare that tutorial. I would like to remind you that this is the part B of the sequence to sequence learning series. Please check out the previous part to refresh the necessary background knowledge in order to follow this part with ease. Here is the sequence to sequence learning series. You can access all my sequence to sequence learning videos on Murat Karakaya Academy YouTube channel, also on Medium. Last time we have seen the part A. Actually, I prepare up to part H. You can ask why we have so many parts. Our aim is to code encoder-decoder model with attention. However, I would like to develop the solution by showing the shortcomings of the other possible solutions. Therefore, in first two parts, part A and part B, we will observe that initial models have their own weaknesses, and we will discuss how to fix their weaknesses. We also understand why encoder-decoder paradigm is so powerful after these parts. Please patiently follow the parts as we develop a better solution. I would like to remind our simple sequence-to-sequence problem, the reverse sequence problem. Assume that we are given a parallel dataset including X as input and Y as the output, such that ith value of X and ith value of Y has some relationship. In the tutorial, I will generate X and Y parallel datasets such that Y sequence will be the reverse of the given X sequence. For example, if the ith of the X sequence is given as 3291, the output sequence, the ith value of Y, is the reverse input sequence of ith value of X, such that 1, 9, 2, and 3. I will call this parallel dataset the reverse sequence problem. In real life, like machine language translation, image captioning, etc., we are given or built a parallel dataset by ourselves. X sequences and corresponding Y sequences. However, to set up an easily traceable example, I opt to set Y sequences as the reverse of X sequences. However, you can create X and Y parallel datasets as you wish, sorted, reverse sorted, odd, or even numbers selected from the input sequence. It's up to you. Here I didn't try to use some translation examples because in translation examples or image captioning examples require lots of pre-processing which complicates the solution. Actually, my focus is on to how to create an encoder-decoder model, and I would like to discuss its details. So for me, even with that simple example, we can handle how to create encoder-decoder model with you. We use the parallel dataset to train a sequence-to-sequence model which would learn how to convert or transform an input sequence from X dataset to an output sequence in Y dataset. Important. In the reverse sequence problem, the input and output sequence lengths are fixed and same. In part E, we will change the problem and the solution such that we will be dealing with the variable length sequences after we built the basic encoder-decoder model. Let's talk about how to configure our problem and with what parameters. Number of input time steps will determine how many tokens, distinct events, numbers, words, etc. in the input sequence depending on your problem. Number of features, how many feature dimensions used to represent one token, distinct event, number, word, etc. in the given and the output sequences. Here we use one-hot encoding to represent the integers. The length of one hot encoding vector is the number of feature size. Thus, the greatest integer will be number of features minus 1. If we set here, as you see the number of features here, as if we set 10, then the greatest integer will be in the sequence, input or output, will be represented 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 1 in the one hot encoding. So let me do it for you. Now, number of time steps is 4, so means that input and output sequence will have 4 integers. But we don't supply the integers to our model, but we are gonna supply some representation. For that, I choose to represent the integers with one hot encoded format. So, for example, this is the one hot encoded for the number 1. And for the number 9, you see this is the one hot encoding for number 9. And train size is the basically number of samples in the train dataset. Test size is the number of samples in the test dataset. After creating these, we will check the train shape and test shape. We noticed that 2000 samples. In each of them, there are 4 by 10 values. Why 4? Because it is a time steps. For each sample, there will be 4 time steps. And we already discussed that for each time step, integer will be represented by one hot encoded vector. The vector size is 10. I hope that you already know, especially recurrent neural network concepts and LSTMs. If you would like to refresh your knowledge, you can check the Murat Karakaya Academy resource on YouTube and Medium or Collab. Today we are gonna talk about how to use LSTM layer in a recurrent neural network structure to solve that sequence-to-sequence problem. In part A, we observed that multi-layer perceptron network does not perform very well. Actually, MLP is not able to learn sequence-to-sequence learning. Why? Because it is the MLP pays attention all it is inputs equally and is not aware of the time dimensionality of the input-output relationship. Thus, MLP does not relate input and output understandably sequence order. In other words, time dimension. Therefore, in this part, we will create several models using recurrent neural networks, which are known to be good at understanding the sequences. In Keras, we have 3 kinds of implementation of recurrent neural networks. I opted out using LSTM. I would like to give you a quick reminder about LSTM structure and how we use it. It's really important to understand the rest of the tutorial. Please pay attention. LSTM has 3 important parameters. For the time being, actually there are lots of parameters. For our case, 3. The first one is units, which is a positive integer showing the dimensionality of the output space. Another one is return sequences, which is a Boolean value, true or false, to return the last output or not in the output sequences or the full sequences. Default value is false. And the last one that we are interested with, return state, it is also a Boolean value, true or false, whether to return the last state in addition to the output. Default is false. The first parameter units indicates the dimension of the output vector matrix. It has nothing to do with number of neurons. There is no number of neurons in LSTM structure. It's not like dense layer. It's very important information for you. The last 2 parameters, return sequences and return state, determines what the LSTM layer outputs. LSTM can return 4 different sets of results, 4 different sets of results, according to the given parameters. If you don't provide any parameter values, then it's gonna be default output. The default output is the last hidden state. In other words, hidden state of the last time step. If you provide return sequences as true, then all hidden states, it means that hidden state of all the time steps. If you provide the parameter return state true, then you will get hidden state, the last hidden state, plus last hidden state, yes, again, and plus last cell state of the last time step. If you provide return sequences true and return stated true, then you will get all hidden states, hidden state of all the time steps, plus last hidden state and plus cell state. We are gonna use these four different results to create LSTM layers connected to each other and of course create a model to solve sec-to-sec problem. Again, if you are not familiar with LSTM, you would like to consider refreshing your knowledge by watching or reading below resources. Let me first set up the number of units as 16. We are gonna create our first model with LSTM with default output. It means that LSTM will return us the last hidden state. Hidden state of the last time step. They are the same. The size of the output vector will be as number of units. Let's begin with a model using single LSTM layer. I will use Keras Sequential API for the sake of simplicity. However, in the following examples, I will use Keras Functional API. I hope that you already know functional APIs. In the model, I will use repeat vector layer. This layer simply repeats the input n times. You provide the n. Here I make a copy of LSTM output as the number of n times. In our example, it is 4. So that dense layer can have an output shape of batch size 4, 10. Remember, 4 is our time steps, 10 is the feature number, so the representation of each integer in time steps. Let's go over the code together. Here I initialize the sequential API, giving a name, and then I provide the input saying that n time steps by n features, 4 by 10 then. We are gonna use single LSTM layer with default output. So I just provide the LSTM and with the number of units, I didn't provide any return sequences or return state parameters. So LSTM will return us only the default output. Then using that default output, because I know that the shape of the default output will be only 16 scalar values, I using the repeat vector, I will repeat n time steps, which is 4. 4 time steps, the same 16 numbers. So now I have 4 times LSTM outputs. And I will supply these as an input to the dense layer and expect it to print me out or give me or predict n features, which is the number of representations. It is 10, remember. Let me compile the model. I already compiled categorical cross entropy and optimizer ADEM. You can use any optimizer you like. The matrix as usual is accuracy. Then I will put the summary. Now check out the summary. Now the LSTM layer, I have not provided any return sequences or return state values parameters, so it is the default output, only 16 scalar values. By using repeat vector, I made it batch size, time steps, and the feature, so it is gonna be like that. And dense state, dense layer will output 10. Why 10? Because here in the number of the dense neurons is n features, which is 10. And why 4? Because 4 by 16 number is given and it has to produce 4 by 10. So I will use 4x10 to decide the output sequence. Okay, now we can run the compiled model by using in part A I already introduced train and test function that I coded myself. I prepare for carrying training and testing of a given model with early stopping mechanism. Now you can access the full code on Colab for that reason. Here I just run the model with train and test data and I set that to be silent. After running this in the 100 epochs, it's finished, it stops and produce me the accuracy ratios. You see that for the train and test data set, accuracy is less than 40%. And you see that we already accessed the plateau and this is the loss diagram. Let me show you a couple of examples and you see that all the examples are false. And let's check one of them. You see that expected output and the predicted output has almost no relationship. So what's our observation now? Predicted accuracy is below 40% for even training data. Thus, we need to improve this model by increasing its learning capacity. You know, in general, in neural network models, in order to increment a model capacity and improve accuracy, in general, we could increment number of units, number of layers, number of epochs, or training samples. We can try all of them on the above model. For example, I incremented the LSTM unit and noted the result below. Now, if you notice that we already done for the 16 as the unit number and the result is like that. Even I incremented double or four times incremented, the result has not changed at all. So, incrementing the capacity of the model does not end up with the incrementing the prediction accuracy. So let's increment the number of LSTM layer as a second chance. Okay, we are now gonna continue with a model using multiple LSTM layers. As I discussed above, LSTM layer can return four different sets of outputs. We will begin with a model containing multiple LSTM layer, which are connected to each other with default output. It means that the previous LSTM will return only last hidden state and the next LSTM will use it as an input. That is, the default output last hidden state of the first LSTM layer is supplied to the next LSTM layer as inputs. Let me go over to the code here. Again, I am going to use the sequential API of Keras. Here is the input layer. Now, this is gonna be the first LSTM layer. And I didn't provide any parameters such as return sequences true or return state true. So it's gonna return only default output. And number of units, we already know it is 16. By getting this result, I need to repeat the output of the first LSTM n times. Time steps again because the second LSTM layer receives 4x LSTM outputs as the input vector. Why? Remember that LSTM layer requires 3-dimensional input, mostly in the size, batch size, time steps, and features. But the output is only one dimensional. So by using the repeat vector, I make it 2-dimensional. And using the batch size, it becomes 3 dimensions. So that the second LSTM here will use the output of the first LSTM by after repeated vectors. Then I will use the LSTM output again with the repeated vector so that the dense layer will end up with here again with 4x10. If I don't repeat before, it will end up only by 10. Again, you need to use the categorical cross entropy as a loss function, but you can use any optimizer at all. I use the accuracy as we talked before. So that's the summary. We can run the again test and train function. By using test and train function, we can run the model and test the model. Here is the result. Train and test is still below 40%. And we already reached the plateau. You see that. Let's check the some examples. Let's check one example. 160. This is the expected, but it only remembers 6, for example. Okay, let's continue. So the prediction accuracy at test data has not changed at all. Before trying to increase the capacity of the model, we can use other ways of connecting LSTM layers as follows. Now, we are going to create a model containing multiple LSTM layers again, but now connecting them with return sequence through output. As discussed above, LSTM layer can return 4 different sets outputs. In the last model, we already used the default output to connect to LSTM layers. Now, as a second option, we will create a model containing multiple LSTM which are connected to each other by return sequence through output. It means that all hidden states at each time steps. That is, all hidden states of the first LSTM layer is supplied to the next LSTM layer as input. Moreover, we also let the second LSTM layer return all hidden states as the input to the dense layer. This is the second change in the model. To connect the last LSTM layer with dense layer, we use the time distributed layer this time, so that for each time step, the second LSTM output, the dense layer will generate one prediction at a time. Let's go over to the code. Here we use still the sequential API of Keras. Here we have the input layer. Now we have the LSTM with the number of units plus the second parameter now is return sequences true. Now the result of the return sequence true is a two-dimensional vector, so we don't need to use here repeat vector anymore. The second LSTM layer will receive directly the output because batch size plus two-dimensional makes three-dimensional, so LSTM can already ready to use three-dimensional input. Here still we use the return sequences so that this layer will also return three-dimensional data. So to make the dense layer work with three-dimensional data, I will use right now time distributed. So for each dimension, time dimension, dense layer will return n features prediction. Here categorical cross entropy, ADEM and accuracy is the same. Let's see here. So LSTM, first LSTM output will be three-dimensional result. 4 by 16, because 16 is the number of units. Here the second LSTM is connected directly because the output is now three-dimensional, so it can work with the input and it will produce three-dimensional because we said that return sequence is true. By using the time distributed data, the dense layer will return 4 by 10, so 4 time steps with 10 features. Let's run this model by using the R function, train and test function, and let's check the result. Here results a little bit increased and you see the plateau here. Okay, now check out some examples. Still you notice that these examples are not correct at all. Let's talk about the observations so far. Prediction accuracy at test data has improved from 39 to 56. This observation indicates that how to connect multiple LSTM layers are important. If you compare the latest model with the previous model, it's clear that we are exchanging more information between LSTM layer and also with the dense layer. So we are exchanging more information between first and second LSTM layer plus between the second LSTM layer and dense layer. Even the parameter numbers are equal. It is very, very important. So we didn't actually increase the the complexity of the model, but we increase the information exchange. In the previous model, we have 16 distinct numbers as the output of the LSTM. On the other hand, in the latest model, we have 64, 4 by 16 distinct numbers. Remember, in the first model, we replicate 16 numbers by 4 times, but still they are the same numbers. Let's continue trying other ways of connecting LSTM layers as follows. In the third model, we are gonna create again a multiple LSTM layers model by connecting them with return state through output case. A model containing multiple LSTM layers which are connected to each other by the return state parameter set to true. So it will return last hidden cells returns. Remember that when return state true, we will receive three different results at the same time. The first one is for LSTM output, so that's the last hidden state, the default output. The second one is exactly the same default output again. And the third one is the last cell state of the last time step. So we are gonna get three different results at the same time from one layer. So far we use Keras sequential API to create the models, but all layers in a sequential model should have a single output tensor. That's the rule in Keras. Here we discussed that we are going to receive three outputs. So multi-output layer, such as LSTM layer with return state true. We need to use the Keras sequential API. Before continue, you need to like, maybe you would like to refresh your knowledge about Keras functional API, which will help you follow the rest of the tutorial, so you can check my videos. Please note that we use the second and third outputs of the first LSTM layer to initialize the next LSTM layer state. Remember, the first LSTM will return three outputs. We are gonna use second and the third outputs. These are the second and the third output to initialize the next LSTM layer state as last hidden state, last cell state. Thus, the second LSTM layer starts with the last state of the first LSTM layer. That's very important. As an input for the next LSTM layer, now we are talking about input. For the next LSTM layer, we can use the first output, which is the default output. Remember here, the default output, which is the last hidden state. But since it is two-dimensional batch size features and LSTM layers requires three-dimensional input, we need to repeat it again by the time steps. Here is the code. Now, I am going to use the pay attention that Keras functional API, and in the functional API you give a name to the layer, and then by using that layer name you provide the input here. Here in creating of that the functional LSTM layer, we already provide the return state true. After that, if you provide the input to that LSTM layer, it will return three different results. We use the last two results as the states for the next layer. And the first result will be repeated, okay, with the repeat vector, as the time steps four times. So now we can initialize the second LSTM, again with the return sequences true. And the second LSTM is initialized with the as the states of the previous LSTM layer, and so that the second LSTM initialize with the previous states. And now we have to get the all the time states, and then we can now connect these all states with the time distributed layer, so that dance will create n number of features or n number of features time output for each time step of the STM2. So here again we use the categorical transentropy adem accuracy. Let's check the numbers here. So the input layer 4x10, no problem. LSTM, the first LSTM is now, you see that here is the sum numbers here. If you are interested in the output shape, you can watch my LSTM video about understanding the outputs. Okay. And then repeat. And then the second LSTM. And this is the time distributed dense layer. All right. Now we can train and test that model. We see that the accuracy increased up. And now for the first time we see some true predictions. Look at here. Some true predictions. Now let's summarize. Prediction accuracy at test data has improved from 39 to 56 in two models, in the first 2 months. Now it is up to 90% in the last model. Again, this observation indicates that how to conduct multiple LSTM is important. If you compare the latest model with the previous models, it's clear that we are exchanging far more information between LSTM layers, even though the number of parameters the same of the model. So if you check the number of the models parameters, which I am talking about here, okay, all the models have the same total parameters to learn. Note that we do not only provide the output of the previous LSTM layer to the next one, but we also provide the last state of the previous LSTM layer to the next layer as the initial state. Okay, so the second LSTM layer is initialized with the first LSTM layer's states. In the previous models, we only provide the inputs to the next layer. Now, in the latest model, we have also provided initial values for hidden cell states of the next LSTM layer as well. Notice that we still replicate the hidden states by 4 times using repeat vector layer. In the next model, we will change that. We provide the input to the next layer as it is. We are going to create a model using again multiple LSTM layers, but this time we are going to use return sequences true and return state true options. So as we discussed above, there are 4 different sets of outputs. In the last option, we are going to use both of the return set sequences true and return state true. When we use these options, then the LSTM layer will return 3 arrays of real numbers, 3 outputs. The first output is all hidden states. It means that hidden state of all the time steps, and last hidden state of the last time step. And the third one is last cell state, which is the cell state of the last time step. As an input for the next LSTM layer, we can use the first output, which is all hidden states. And all hidden states, you know that it is 3-dimensional one. So time steps, features, and batch size dimensions. So we don't need to use the repeat vector to provide the first output as an input to the second LSTM layer. The second and the third outputs, which are the last hidden state and last cell state, we are going to use as the initial states for the second LSTM layer, as we did in the previous example. Here it is the input. The LSTM layer will return sequences and return states. We get the input, and the output will be 3 different set of outputs. Using the last two, we create the state of the next LSTM. For the next LSTM, we created and we set that return the sequences only, because it's enough for the output dense layer. And we initialize the second LSTM layer with the states we get from the first LSTM. Then by using the time distributed dense layer, we already get the output. All right. So we create our model, compile it. Here is the summary. Now pay attention, the input is 4x10 as expected. Then we have the LSTM. Actually we have three kinds of outputs, but we cannot see here because the time, the space does not permit. Okay. As I said that if you are interested in how that output shapes occurs at LSTMs, you can watch my video, Understanding Output Shape of LSTM. Here the two LSTMs are connected to each other directly. And then we use the time distributed dense layer to create 4x10 output as the batch number. Now let's run and see the result. Now you notice that the result gets above the 95%, which is very good. So let's see some examples. You see that only one example, only one prediction is wrong, but all the other predictions are correct, which is very good. Prediction accuracy at test data has improved previous models 39, 56 and 90 now up to 97, which is very good. Again, this observation indicates that how to connect multiple LSTM layers is important. If we compare the latest model with the previous model, it's clear that we are exchanging more information between LSTM layers, even though the number of parameters is the same. Let's check the parameters. 4000. You see that? 4010. Actually, we didn't increment the learning capacity of the model, the number of the parameters. Okay. In the latest model, we have provided previous LSTM last hidden and self states as the initial values to the next LSTM layer, hidden and self states, and previous LSTM all hidden states as inputs to the next LSTM layer. Alright. In other words, second LSTM layer starts to operate the last hidden state and last self state of the first LSTM layer and consumes the first LSTM's all hidden states to produce the output. As a result, during training, second LSTM layer is conditioned to produce expected outputs given by the first LSTM layer's outputs, and the first LSTM is conditioned to produce such outputs that second LSTM layer would be successful in prediction. So both LSTMs are cooperating with each other. Thus, we can argue that first LSTM layer encodes the input X in a representation that second LSTM layer can decode it to produce the expected output. The encoded representation of input X in the last model is composed of all hidden states, last hidden state and self states. That is the context vector. Is all hidden states, last hidden states and self states of the first LSTM layer. The first LSTM layer is called as encoder, whereas the second LSTM layer is called as decoder. We can use more LSTM layers to construct encoder or decoder as well. Now, let's just go over again. Last model seems to be successful with n time steps is 4. Last model is able to achieve around 97% accuracy. But what if we set the time steps to 8? Or what if we set the time steps to 16? I already did some simulations for that. With 4, we already seen these results. But when we double the sequence size, now the accuracy falls down dramatically. When the 16, the sequence size, it means that there are 16 integers in input and output sequences, of course. Now, the success is too low. That is, all the models degrade their performance when we request them to deal with longer sequences. Now, the question is that, how to handle longer sequences with the existing models? We have already developed 4 models. How can we handle longer sequences? Generic solution in artificial neural network is increment the model capacity. How to increment the model capacity? You can increment the number of units, layers, epochs, training samples. Remember, we already did the units. We already did the layers. You can try increasing epochs or training as well. But I did it. All of them. You can try with that collab page. The link of that collab page is under the video description. However, even the length of the input sequence is increased a little bit on the double, for example, 4 to 8. The model cannot catch up with it to provide similar accuracy, applying all the above measures. For example, I just made the sequence size 16, so 16 integers input, 16 integers output, doubling the LSTM cell numbers to 33. The last model performance only 10% improves, so above 37 to 47. So it, you see that it does not cope with it. Conclusion: LSTM cells and layers are designed to capture sequential relations, which is good. Best results achieved with LSTM return sequences and return state is true. Okay. In general, using LSTM layers in a simple feed-forward network model does not accomplish a scalable accurate solution. The scalable is important here. LSTM layers could not handle, as we see, or remember or relate longer sequences. That's the main problem so far. Moreover, input or output sequence length would not always be fixed. If we change the problem such that the output sequence is the inverse of the input sequence and only consists of the first appearance of the duplicated numbers. For example, if it is 3, 2, 3, 5, 2, which is 5, sequence length is 5. Now the output will be 2, 5, 3 because the first appearance of the numbers. You see that the output sequence does not have a fixed length. Output sequence do have a variable length, and input sequence also can be variable. Remember, in the translation from A to B example, each sentence in language A and B easily can have different number of words. New question: how can you create a model to handle variable length input output? How can you train such a model? A mitigating solution could be that you can use the padding, so adding some special symbols, mostly zero, in front of or in the end of each sequences, that all the sequence has an equal length with the maximum length sequence length in the dataset. There are many drawbacks of this solution. Few of them are waste of space and computation power. In real life, sometimes we don't know the maximum sequence length, for example, online translation. In some applications, input sequence is continuous, like speech recognition does not stop so that you can calculate. Thus, you cannot wait until the end of the sequence to progress, i.e. padding it. Alright. Now we need a better solution, we understand that. We can change the model structure at all. Instead of adding more layers or more units, we can change the model structure. So far we use a single model for training and inference testing. In the next part we will focus on how to create such a model. I mean a basic encoder decoder. So please follow with me to the next part C. We are gonna create encoder decoder architecture together. Thank you for watching.